Hello, friends. Welcome to Engineering Today. And we're here again with some latest updates. Today, we'll first discuss some updates regarding SpaceX Starlink satellite speed and Blue Origin's 20 years of journey. So, let's get going. SpaceX has recently launched Starlink, in which the company offers to provide faster satellite internet service, has achieved latency under 20 milliseconds, recorded as par on ground-based broadband. Last Friday, SpaceX made a detailed presentation with the gathered data from the satellite internet and sent it to the Federal Communications Commission, FCC, which was spotted by Reddit users. The two benchmark tests were conducted in Ookla's speedtest.net site, showed Starlink achieved a 102 to 103 megabits per second of download speed, 40 to 42 megabits per second of upload speed, and a latency of 18 to 19 milliseconds. SpaceX's Director of Satellite Policy, David Goldman, also attached a letter along with the presentation, which says Starlink's initial beta tests are hitting below a latency of 30 milliseconds compared to the average latency for fixed broadband in the U.S., which is 25 milliseconds, and on mobile networks is 48 milliseconds, according to speedtest.net. SpaceX made the filing after the company publicly announced that Starlink is already achieving higher than 100 megabits per second of download speed. The benchmark provided to the FCC proves their statement. Both benchmarks took place on June 30th in Seattle, Washington, when SpaceX only had about 500 Starlink satellites in Earth's orbit. However, the company now has more than 700 satellites around the planet. Eventually, they want to launch thousands of Starlink into space to extend the network coverage and cross the download speed over 1 gigabits per second. According to presentation, SpaceX is currently manufacturing 120 Starlink satellites each month. The company is also producing several user terminals, which consumers can use at their homes to receive the benefits of satellite-based broadband. In coming days, SpaceX plans to hold a public beta trial for users across multiple U.S. states. Now, let's get into the details of Blue Origin's 20 years of journey. On September 8, 2020, one of America's finest aerospace manufacturing companies, Blue Origin, completed its 20 years. Jeff Bezos founded Blue Origin in the year 2000 with a goal to send humans in space, providing a budget-friendly but reliable space travel. Jeff Bezos started growing his interest about space exploration and planets when he was a teenager. He was very good in mathematics, eventually became a topper in his high school when he was 18 years old. In 1982, he told the Miami Herald, an American daily newspaper, that he planned to build space hotels, amusement parks, and colonies for 2 million or 3 million people who would be in orbit. In 1994, Jeff Bezos founded the multinational technology company Amazon and gained $6 billion. Later, in the year 2000, he officially founded Blue Origin Federation LLC in Kent, Washington, with a task of sending people to live and work in space. For the past two decades, rather came into the spotlight, the company was developing heavy rockets quietly. After Jeff Bezos in September 2000, started working on both science vehicles and heavy lifted rocket motors. The company's maintained its secrecy for at least 3 years after its founding. Public first discovered the existence of Blue Origin when Bezos bought land as the company's private suborbital launch and engine test site in Texas. However, that was not the end, as the company still keeps its work in the shadows. Even the company did not allow passing any comments regarding to this story. A reason behind all of this may be the company wants to chase public input. As of 2016, Bezos provided its entire $1 billion annual budget operation from his pocket. That financial support helps the production of several spacecraft and engine prototypes. The company's 9,500-pound Charon Jet Power VTOL test platform made its first and only test flight above Moses Lake in Washington. This was to ensure the company's autonomous guidance and control systems worked just fine. It climbed about 316 feet using its quartet of Rolls-Royce Viper Mark 301 jet engines and kept in a flight museum. The year after that, the company performed another test flight with its Goddard suborbital test vehicle, which was powered by BE-1 rocket engines. Blue Origin's first successful rocket design helped it to reach a height of 300, approximately, feet in just 10 seconds after the liftoff. The company made two more flights in 2007 before being retired. Those test results have led the company to make their new Shepard spacecraft. Blue Origin's new Shepard is a vertical takeoff, vertical landing, human-rated suborbital rocket that's capable of carrying crews and cargo out to the Kármán line, the internationally defined boundary between Earth and space. The new Shepard was named after a well-known Mercury-era astronaut, Alan Shepard. Production of new Shepard was initially started in 2006, but after the completion of the BE-3 110,000-pound force liquid hydrox engine, the vehicle finally reached its state of worthiness. The new Shepard was based on a two-part design and consisting a six-person crew capsule sits on top of the 60-foot-tall reusable VTOL rocket. It's a vertical takeoff rocket with speeds reaching Mach 3. The new Shepard rocket could separate at a height of 100 kilometers, approximately, and eventually return to Earth, while the crew capsule could make a gentle landing with its three parachutes guiding back to the ground. Up until now, Blue Origin made three new Shepard rockets, among them the first one partially destroyed during a test flight in 2015. Though the crew capsule on the top of the rocket was unharmed, the vehicle itself took some damage. Later, the rocket has made five successful flights from its second attempt between 2015 and 2016. In 2017, New Shepard, reusing the same engine from before, carried multiple scientific experimental payloads into Earth's orbit. Blue Origin's the New Shepard 4 flights were scheduled to launch in 2018 with crews on board, but the company delayed those flights for the past 2 years and is still waiting for a potential crewed flight in this year. Apart from the New Shepard mission, Blue Origin has another goal on its path. The company is currently working on a new spacecraft called the New Glenn, which might perform a flight test in 2020. The heavy-lift orbital launch vehicle, named after John Glenn, which the company first began working on in 2012, but the details of the rocket were revealed publicly in 2016. According to the information, the rocket has two models, one with 270-foot-tall, consisting two-stage, another one is slightly bigger than the previous one, consisting of an extra stage with a height of 313 feet tall. The larger variant will be able to exceed low Earth orbit. The New Glenn is somewhat familiar to the venerated Saturn V that first landed people on the moon. Like its predecessor, the New Glenn will be a reusable rocket, like SpaceX's Falcon 9, to get into space. Instead of using the previous BE-3 engine, Blue Origin's New Glenn will be powered by new BE-4, which uses a mixture of liquid oxygen and methane as fuel. The company says that the BE-4 will be powerful enough to provide 550,000-pound force of thrust and could carry 13 tons of cargo in each trip for lower orbit. BE-3 engines will still be used in the second stage of the rocket to deliver the payload into the correct orbit after passing the Kármán line. In addition, New Glenn's first stage will guide itself back to Earth after separation and land automatically in the oceanic landing pad, which is somewhat similar to SpaceX's Falcon 9. Blue Origin plans to go to the moon and eventually beyond that. In April, NASA started distributing contracts for its Lunar Artemis program, which aims to land the first woman on lunar surface, more specifically on the south pole of the moon by 2024. Blue Origin received an amount of $573 million along with SpaceX and Dynetics received their funding to help the agency's Artemis program. All three private aerospace companies have a deadline of February 2021 to build their own lunar landers before NASA starts thinning the competitors. "We're going to build a road to space," Bezos said during an interview unveiling the Blue Moon in May. "And then amazing things will happen." The Blue Moon lander will also have two variants like the Glenn. One is for cargo only, which will have enough space to carry multiple tons of rovers along with previously constructed habitats. The other version of Blue Moon lander will have people on it, which was developed in partnership with Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman, and Draper. They each put their contribution. Blue Origin constructed the lander itself, while Lockheed took care of the ascent element, which will shuttle astronauts from the lunar surface back into orbit. Northrop handled the transfer element, which connects Blue Moon to the Orion vehicle, which will fly them out from the Earth. And Draper developed the system avionics. Last month, Blue Origin delivered the 40-foot prototype to NASA at Johnson Space Center. Testing this engineering mock-up for crew interaction is a step toward making this historic mission real. The learning we get from full-scale mock-up can't be done any other way. Benefiting from NASA's expertise and feedback at this early stage allows us to develop a safe commercial system that meets the agency's needs, said Brent Sherwood, Blue Origin's Vice President of Advanced Development Programs, in a statement. "We'll run out of energy," Bezos said during the presentation. "This is just arithmetic. It's going to happen. Do we want stasis and rationing, or do we want dynamism and growth? This is an easy choice. We know what we want. We just have to get busy." That's all for today, my friends. We'll soon come back with more updates. Till then, goodbye and take care. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.